Now that Jurassic World Alive 1.3 is available to everybody, I'm excited to talk about Strike Towers with you. I know this is one thing that a lot of people were wanting for me to cover, and they were wanting in the game. It's something more than just darting dinosaurs in PvP. Now you have PvE, which, thanks to my viewers, I was informed that this is player versus environment, a great new addition to the game. The first thing that you're gonna notice is, this is the screen that I had during the beta. As you can see, the very first thing you're gonna notice is, yes, the supply drops pop off the map. You also notice a lot more detail in the buildings. They look like maybe they're elevated or there's some shadow there. It's not a lot, but just a little bit of extra detail. And I believe that comes out of the Google Maps. There's the street also has the hashes in the middle of the road. The next thing that you're gonna notice is there's the circle around your figure, or the dot where your figure would be, your location. And then the next thing that you're gonna notice is there's a circle beyond that, and that's actually going to be your drone radius circle. For this specific account, because I had to start a brand new account, it was at 150 meters and it actually tells you that on the circle. If you have VIP, that is going to be 200, and I imagine it would tell you there as well. Then what you will notice is in this screenshot, this is what it looks like once the strike towers are in place. Notice that supply drops don't disappear and the strike towers don't just appear randomly. They actually appear on top of selected supply drops. Now, as far as I know, at this point in time, the strike towers can either be white or they can be blue, and there are different levels. My guess is that you can have gold and purple or pink and probably maybe green, just depending on how they decide to do this. But it definitely feels like, and it looks like, the strike towers coincide with different levels. The white strike towers are going to have 3 rounds in them. The blue strike towers have 5 rounds in them. And those are the only 2 that I actually participated in and took battle to. I never even saw a gold or pink or green, so I'm just speculating on that, but it makes sense since those are the classes of dinosaurs. These are actually going to be on cooldown. You can either have the supply drop, could either be a treasure hunt, which I'll go into at a later time. They can be a white strike tower, they can be a blue strike tower, or they can just be the normal supply drop. So these strike towers do have cooldown periods, and just know that even if you start a battle in one of these strike towers, after a battle or 2 battles or 3 battles, it actually could go away in cooldown period, which would actually force you to move over to another strike tower. Now, you're not going to lose your progress along the way, but it is going to make you go out and explore a different part of your city, town, wherever you live. Additionally, these strike towers are free. You don't have to have any coins. If you do lose 3 battles within a strike tower, you can choose to continue your progress. The first option is 5 hard cash, and then I imagine if you lose there, and I don't know because I never did it, but if you lose after you've paid to continue, I think the cost goes up, but I'm not sure if it gives you 3 more battles or if it's a 1 strike and you're out type thing. Once you're close enough to interact with the strike tower, the first thing that you're gonna notice is the title. This one is called Toughen Up. Now, if you hit the eye with the circle around it, it's going to tell you about that strike tower. It also shows you in red how much longer the strike tower is going to be available for you to battle. You see that it's blue in color, and you can see that I already have 1 win, so I did forget to record that very first battle. But another thing to look at is round 1, round 2, and then after you win round 3, you will get a mystery incubator. And then at the end, after you defeat this strike tower 5 times, you will get a rare incubator. Also under that, you see how many losses you have. Those will fill up with red strikes, and then you have the option to battle. Also, you have the flag off to the upper, what is that, the upper right hand side of the screen. If that supply drop is in a bad location, and that doesn't mean it's inconvenient for you, but that means maybe it's not accessible, maybe that means it's dangerous to get to, things of that nature, you can actually report that. So what you see now is it tells you, toughen up. Your opponent's team. Your opponents are a team of high health creatures. Use creatures that can increase their damage and take these tanks down over multiple turns. So you're not gonna wanna use a bunch of dinosaurs with low health. You're gonna wanna use things that can go through armor or can do a lot of damage or can reduce their damage. The next thing that you're gonna notice is under your team, and remember, I had to start a brand new account in order to run the beta. I couldn't use it on my normal account, unfortunately, but you're gonna set your team in your decks, and then you can actually look to see what it is that the strike tower is all about, and then you can put in your team accordingly, so you get to plan ahead and kind of prepare for these. But you're gonna pick four of your eight. It doesn't randomly pick the four. You actually get to pick the four of the eight dinosaurs that you're gonna wanna take into battle, and it shows you who your two opponents are, and it also shows you their level. Now notice both of those dinosaurs are higher level than me. The next thing you're gonna notice is the load up screen looks very familiar, and it should. It was on the load up screen for the game previously, and I don't know if your time is going to stay at, what was that, like 4 minutes, 2400 seconds, or if that was just part of the beta. Since you are playing the AI, I wouldn't imagine that's gonna give you 4 minutes to make a choice, but who knows. So then you basically, you're just going to fight dinosaurs from there on out, just as you would against a normal opponent, only this time they are AI. As you can see, they are stronger than I am, although I don't know if they would be stronger than I was if I had my main account. That's one thing that I will not know until this update goes live. And when you are victorious, as you see, I knocked out two dinosaurs, your progress bar moves up. Now, if this strike tower goes away, or if you can't continue, say you're at a doctor's office and you're only there for a short time and then it's time for you to leave, your progress is actually saved and you can leave and then come back at a later time to any, I believe, any of the blue colored or the same colored strike towers as you were already in. Now, once you get to level three, you will see that they've increased the level of the dinosaurs that you're facing, and they've also added another dinosaur to the mix. So now it's a 3-on-4. So things are definitely getting more difficult as you progress through this. I will, spoiler alert here, and just let you know that I did win this round, but I don't even think I attempted to go beyond that because these dinosaurs are already way stronger, and in order for me to beat the three that were here, I basically had no health left on my third dinosaur, and my fourth dinosaur was ready to be fainted, knocked out, whatever you want to call it as well. So once you deliver that final knockout blow, you see I knocked out the three, it's going to move up and you're going to earn the mystery incubator. Now I will say that you do earn rewards all the way up through each of these rounds. I believe it was just coins for the first two rounds and then you got that special incubator. And there it is, it's Giraffe the Titan. So I'm gonna get coins, I'm gonna get darts. It's just like a regular incubator that you would get out of the shop or a battle incubator. Not sure what the 99 means. I think that's just kind of a placeholder for that particular dinosaur. It looks out of place there, but 19 rare Giraffe the Titan. It's pretty nice. And you see it only takes 40 to unlock. I thought rares were higher than that actually. And now I'm gonna skip ahead. This was a white strike tower. Just kind of gonna run through this. It's the same basic principle. The very first round, you face one dinosaur. It wasn't a whole lot of effort for my level two Velociraptor to make quick work of the level three Dilophosaurus Gen 2, I believe. And there you go. And as you can see on this one, after two wins, you get a mystery incubator. And then after three wins, you get the common incubator. As you see, I was able to take out the second two dinosaurs. The check mark comes and I get, I think it's just kind of an equivalent of a 15-minute incubator. So I'm gonna get a few coins, a handful of darts, a common dinosaur, and then a little bit of rare DNA as well. And then you go in for the third and final time to try to defeat the head dinos, the boss dinos, whatever you want to call them. And one thing that I do want to bring to attention is this actual strike tower is a different themed strike tower. This one is power players. And so if you read the comments below it or the description below it, it says your opponents are a team of stunners and creatures that with negative status effects. Use immune creatures like the Metrodon and its cousins or fast creatures like raptors to defeat. So it kind of helps you out and lets you know what is it that I should be bringing into this strike tower. Also know that this is level 3 of the strike tower white, for lack of a better term. Maybe it's strike tower gray. That's probably actually more accurate. But all of their dinosaurs at the top when you're doing the final round are all higher level than any of the dinosaurs that I have. Again, I don't have a way to check that because I wasn't running my normal deck, my normal team, whenever I was doing this. And they're not easy to beat. I mean, even with the dinosaurs that I had, as you see, I lost there. But when you go back in, you will notice, and in fact, maybe I didn't beat this. If you noticed, it showed a strike underneath the screen there. When you lose, you can see the strike goes into your losses column. And because these dinosaurs were stronger than mine and I didn't have a whole lot of options to choose good matchups, I did lose all 3 rounds of this. And then it gave me the third and final strike, which is never good. And then because I did lose and could not continue on to get that incubator, it did give me the option that I could continue for 5 hard cash if I wanted to do that. So there you go. That is the first look as to the strike towers. I think they're a really nice addition to the game. I think visually the game looks great. The supply drops really pop. You're not gonna miss those. They don't even blend in at all with the background. The improved graphics, I think on the battle screens, it looks phenomenal. It looks, I don't know if it translates really well on your mobile device or whatever you're watching this on, but whenever you actually open up the game for the first time and start playing, you're going to love the new graphics. I think everything just stands out and looks a little bit more crisp. Strike towers, like I said, are a great added dimension to the game. I don't have any breakdown of what you get in those. I'm sure MetaHub is going to be dissecting the contents of the incubators as quickly as possible. Just not really a whole lot of data to go off of. And honestly, I was more just trying to get the flow and the hang of what it is that this new thing is. I wasn't really diving in and trying to dissect everything as far as, well, you get this much and you get this much and your odds of getting this. And I didn't have a large enough sample size anyways to start trying to track that. But just know that in the coming days, I'm sure there will be information out as far as the breakdown. I feel pretty confident in saying the rewards for these strike towers are going to fluctuate with player level, just as they do with all incubators. Obviously, the higher you climb up in these strike towers, meaning the further you progress, the greater the rewards are gonna be. You're definitely going to want to try to field the best team possible. And you can't just put in, like, you can't be dumb and just throw out whatever dinos you want. You actually are going to have to think about what are my opponents gonna be? What type of dinosaurs are my opponents gonna be? And what dinos do I have that can counter those dinos? I think that's a great addition. It keeps the game fresh. It keeps you using dinos that maybe you aren't using in the arena. I will tell you that Proceratosaurus, I believe, I really started to like in these arenas. It seems way undervalued for where it's at and how nobody uses it. I'm not sure if that's gonna stay the same once the new moves and everything are implemented, but I definitely wish I had powered up my Proceratosaurus, and I hope I'm saying that dinosaur correctly, because it actually turned out to be a very useful dinosaur, especially in the battle arenas and the strike towers. I think that is everything. I think that covers all of the bases. If there's something I've missed, I do apologize. I will have more coverage of strike towers as the days go on, but I definitely wanted to get this out so you guys could know right off the bat what was going on. and you can be prepared so you're not just blindly rolling out into this great new update. Let me know in the comments below, what were your first impressions and first thoughts of this new update? Like I said, when I first opened up the app, I was like, wow, this looks phenomenal. And what are you most looking forward to testing out over the next several days? Make sure you subscribe and make sure you hit the alert button. YouTube is always messing with their algorithm and their code and everything else. But if you want the most up-to-date information on Jurassic World 1.3 and all the new features, make sure that you are on notification squad. The best way to do that is by not only subscribing, and in fact, that's not even enough anymore. You have to hit the alert as well. And that's all I got for today. So until next time.